All right, so we are 2 days away, or possibly less, depending on when you're watching this video, from Tesla's Q4 earnings call. So this is a normal quarterly call that gives revenue info to investors and board members and everything, and it's typically stuff that the average person wouldn't really care about. But this one should be extra special. What we do know is how many cars Tesla delivered. They already announced that, which was record-breaking at 112,000 deliveries, with 105,000 cars produced in the fourth quarter. That makes a grand total of 367,500 cars that Tesla delivered in the entirety of 2019. And that includes Model 3s, Model S, and Model X, and Model 3s were the vast majority of those cars. So this is right in line with their guidance that they set out to say how many cars they would be producing by 2019. So we'll see how these record deliveries impacted their revenue and possibly their profit for Q4 and for the entirety of 2019. And we'll hear about that on Wednesday the 29th. Most people expect it to be pretty good, but we'll see for sure on Wednesday. And then on top of that, we'll probably hear some updates about Gigafactory 3 over in Shanghai, because their plan there is to produce high volume at low cost. So we'll see how that's going. We know it's going pretty well, and they've been doing lots of Made in China Model 3 deliveries, and they've been producing very fast, and they're just ramping up. Hopefully we'll get a really good update at the call. But what most people are hoping for, and at this point expecting, because it's on every single Tesla rumors site, is that they're going to announce everything about the Model Y. So what we're hoping is that we're going to hear when production of the Model Y is beginning, or if it has already begun, when deliveries are actually going to start, what the final design is, and what the final specs are regarding range and performance and so on. Now, Tesla hasn't officially announced that they're going to announce any new information at the Q4 earnings call. It's just the next time that they're going out there and talking about their cars, and more than likely, probably 150% chance that someone's going to ask about the Model Y, and they're going to have to answer their question. Also, the last time we officially heard anything about the Model Y from Tesla was at the Q3 earnings call, so it makes a lot of sense that the Q4 earnings call will get some more information. The quote from that call from Elon said, quote, "Regarding Model Y, we're also ahead of schedule on Model Y preparations in Fremont, and we've moved the launch timeline from fall 2020 to summer 2020. There may be some room for improvement there, but we're confident about summer 2020. Then he followed this up by saying they expect to get volume production, which is in excess of 1,000 units per week, by the middle of 2020. What I find interesting is that he said release in summer of 2020, and then volume production at the middle of 2020. So summer could be as late as August, but the middle of 2020 is pretty much June, because that's the 6th month. Maybe you could push it to July and say that's also the middle, but pretty interesting that they're expecting volume production by then. Maybe he was just being broad in all of these terms, but it could be our first clue that they're actually going to start deliveries sooner, because they need time to ramp up to full volume production. I don't want to read too much into that, but at the very least, we're going to get some kind of update about the Model Y. But here's everything we expect to hear about the Model Y at the Q4 earnings call, and this comes based on evidence from the CARB certification, to VIN registrations, to lots of Model Y sightings in the wild, to tweets from people and Reddit posts, all sorts of different sources. And if you want to know all the details about that other sources, you can see my other two videos linked in the description or up here where I detail all of that stuff. First, we expect to hear that Model Y production is beginning soon or already has begun, well ahead of the summer 2020 timeline they talked about at the Q3 earnings. And again, that's based on a lot of rumors from a bunch of different sources all coming together, but that's pretty much what everyone's expecting at this point. We expect to hear that Model Y deliveries are imminent, probably to employees first, starting in February, maybe right after the earnings call a couple days, and then to customers soon after that for the performance version, probably in February or into March. Then we expect to hear a timeline of all the rest of the trims of the car. So after performance gets delivered, how long is it going to be until we see the all-wheel drive long range? How long is it going to be until we see the rear-wheel drive long range? And then the standard range, and then the 7-seater after that. We also expect to hear that the final range of the Model Y is actually 10 to 20 miles better than what it was announced at. And that's based on the CARB certification, where they have their own number of miles, and when you convert that to the EPA standard, it seems like it should be 10 to 20 miles better than what Tesla announced at the event. On top of this, the Model 3 has received a software update since the Model Y's announcement that gave it more range. I think it was 12 more miles on the Model 3. So it makes a lot of sense that they're going to just be putting that same software in the Model Y, which is built on the same platform, and we're going to get those extra miles in the Model Y as well. So for me, getting the long-range all-wheel drive version of the Model Y It's originally stated at 280 miles, but I'm hoping that they're going to announce that it's actually going to be closer to 290 or 300 at production. And this is something Tesla's known for doing, announcing a product with certain specs and then actually making it better before release. And then if you ordered the long-range rear-wheel drive, I'm hoping that instead of 300 miles, it could actually get close to 310 or 320 miles. We expect to hear the final dimensions of the Model Y since they still haven't been announced, and most people expect it's the same width as the Model 3, maybe a couple inches longer than Model 3, but they expect it to be 6 to 8 inches taller than the Model 3, which is quite a bit. If Model Y is indeed launching, we're going to get our final safety ratings on the Model Y because that obviously has to come out before the car goes into production. And Tesla had previously said they expect 5 stars in every category and they expect it to be the safest vehicle in its class, but we haven't seen those official ratings yet. I could see them talking about this at the earnings call since safety is very important to all car manufacturers and specifically Tesla. But I could also see them just waiting on that because if they're announcing the deliveries, they can just put that on the website or talk about it at a different time. We might actually hear how many pre-orders of the Model Y there have been because we know there were a ton of the Cybertruck and they talked about that, but they haven't talked about how many pre-orders of the Model Y there are. And also it's a $2,500 reservation price, which is pretty steep for a lot of people, especially pre-ordering a car. So we'll see how many people are actually really serious about getting the Model Y ahead of time before they've actually seen the car. Regarding design, if they get a chance to talk about this at the earnings call, we expect Tesla to talk about design improvements and overall innovations regarding how they're making Model Y. We know that Tesla is bringing out some new innovations with the Model Y, including shorter wiring and then a possibly new revolutionary stamping process specific to Model Y. When responding to an article about Tesla's design on Twitter, Elon actually responded on the 17th and said, quote, "I think you will appreciate some design elements of the Model Y body design." So there's definitely more to Model Y's design than most people think. A lot of people think it's just a bigger Model 3, but it looks like they're doing quite a bit of innovation on the Model Y, at least with the production of it and with the design of it, so I'm excited to hear all about those new innovations. If they have the time to get this specific, we also expect them to at least acknowledge the fact that the hatchback design has changed. If you look at the original photos, you can see that it's totally straight on the hatchback. And then if you look at the new photos, you can see that it actually slopes over the taillights now. They're probably not going to get that specific on a phone call, but they might at least acknowledge the fact that they've changed some design things and made it overall better and might mention that people have noticed that one and that that's what they're doing. Because the release candidate has that new hatchback with the slope over the taillights. Other than that, here's a couple quick things that they might mention. We've noticed that there's been a bunch of different Model Y prototypes, and they've all had different wheels, these wheels that we haven't seen before. So they might acknowledge those or announce those or talk about those if that's something they're planning to bring out. They could also detail how big people can be if they're going to be in the third row of the Model Y. They could also detail how the second row folds down because I've heard from a few different people who got to sit in the Model Y on Twitter that they actually kind of power fold, they said, but it seems like it's more like you hit a button and then it collapses down and then you have to manually fold them back up. Still a cool design, but something they didn't talk about at the event and we haven't seen, you know, that's not in Model 3, so it might be a cool thing that they're adding in Model Y. They could also detail final performance numbers on the 0 to 60 if maybe they've improved or if they're just exactly the same, which is already really great. They could also detail exactly how much headroom there is, like how tall you can be in the front seat of a Model Y as compared to a Model 3. And then they could also detail the ground clearance. I think they've kind of said it's the same as the Model 3, but a lot of people are curious because it is a crossover and those usually have a higher ground clearance, but it might be something for aerodynamics that they need to keep it low. We'll see about that. And then there's many other details that people are anxiously awaiting about the Model Y, so if they are announcing it there, I hope they announce everything about it. I've heard all kinds of speculation from people saying that Tesla is going to announce that they're starting production on February 1st, to people saying that they're already deep in full production and they're stacking up these vehicles to deliver by February 1st. It'll be really interesting to see if Tesla officially uses this Q4 earnings call to announce the Model Y. At this point, there have been so many rumors swirling around about it that if they announce that they're still on track for the moved up release date of summer of 2020, people are going to be pretty disappointed. Tesla fans are going to be sad, and probably shareholders at this point. It's unfortunate that that would be the case, that people would be sad if they're still on track for summer of 2020, but that's just how rumors swirling around like this work. I do think that if it weren't true at all, none of these rumors were true, and they're still just planning for summer of 2020, that Elon would have acknowledged this on Twitter to at least hush some of the rumors, because he tweets about everything, and that would be really helpful for investors to hear from him that, no, these rumors are false, and it's actually summer of 2020, don't get too excited. Either way, I'll keep you posted, and I'm going to be putting up a video shortly after that earnings call, so make sure you subscribe to see that on Wednesday the 29th, and then also make sure you subscribe for any future videos, because as soon as I get my long-range all-wheel drive Model Y, I'm going to be making all sorts of videos with it. So what do you think will happen at the Q4 earnings call regarding Model Y? Do you think release is imminent and the deliveries are going to start very soon? Or do you think they're still just going to keep to that summer 2020 release? Let me know in the comments below. And in the meantime, I'll be anxiously awaiting every new Model Y update. I'll be anxiously awaiting my delivery of my Model Y. And thanks so much for watching this. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you on the next one, which is coming on Wednesday.